What's going on, guys? Austin Richo here, opening more Marvel Legends series, and this time we have the Avengers set. So, of course, this week we have the Avengers movie coming out. So, by the time you see this on the Friday night that the movie comes out, we will have a review up. So, if you want to see or know our thoughts or opinions on the Avengers movie, you can find the video there on Friday, sometime Friday night. You can find it. But this is the set for Avengers Infinity War, of course, as I mentioned, the new movie. And so, we have some new figures with a build-a-figure of Thanos. You can see Thanos's head there. So we're going to have a movie version of Thanos to put together here at the end. But in this set, as you can see, we have an Iron Man here. And so these are all the movie versions. So we have an Iron Man, Captain America, and Iron Spider or Spider-Man with the Iron Spider suit on. And then also along with it, that goes along with the movie, we do have one of the villains, Proxima Midnight, which is a member of the Black Order, which is like Thanos's henchman. So she comes with that. So all of those are movie versions. And then just some other characters, because this is Marvel Legends, so they always throw in some weird characters to go with it. But with this comic versions, we do have a Songbird, Taskmaster, which we had a Taskmaster from a couple sets ago, but this is like more of the original one. And then the leader of the Serpent Society here. So we have seven characters to open here. And again, each of them comes with a build-a-figure part for Thanos to put together that we will do at the end. So we'll just go ahead and open them, each one of them as we do, and go through each one and show them off and what they do and all that. And then we'll put Thanos together at the end. So let's get into it. So first up here, we have Iron Man. So of course, this is the Iron Man from the Avengers movie in his newest armor. I don't know what it's called. It's not labeled as anything, as a new specific armor, like number or anything. But usually each time he has a movie or anything, he shows up, he has a different type of armor on. And of course, this is a newer one. And I really like the design and color of this. Of course, we'll look at it more in detail. But it does still stick with the normal like red design. And it's got like all metallic, or at least in some parts, like here on the chest it looks metallic, but on the sides here it just looks like a flat red. So it's just kind of mixed in and out of metallic and flat red. But I like the blue and the gold that's added into it. So of course we have the normal face here, so the Iron Man face with the red and the gold plate face covering. That'd be cool if it popped off, which it kind of looks weird, so I thought maybe it did. But it does not pop off the reveal Tony Stark's face or anything. But I like it's got the blue around the eyes. It's kind of hard to see, at least looks like in the camera. But there is like a blue glow around the eyes along with his chest plate or chest, I forget what that's called, but it's like the part that gives him his energy for the suit and stuff, and it's all mixed around out throughout the body. There's like blue going into it, and I really like that about it, and with the gold and everything. So we have the head there, and of course it's normal head, nothing special. Doesn't come with a replacement or anything of like a normal Tony head like the last one did. Then we go to the body, and then of course, as I said, this is like a metallic color. It looks like it's got like a shininess or not shiny, but like a like I said, metallic. It's like glittery and stuff, it looks like. But then like here, the like arms here look normal, and it goes all the way down to here. So it's just this center piece here that has that color paint, and the rest is just all a solid flat. I guess it is kind of shiny, so not flat, but just like a solid red, along with the helmet and everything. But then, of course, as I mentioned, the chest plate here, or piece, we have his arc, I call it the arc reactor, I don't know what it's called, though, his chest part. And then I like, again, with the blue in there, and then, of course, we have the designs going into the suit, all the way down here where it's got more blue. Then in the arms, we have just a bunch of red, again, just more gold and silver going into the armor here, and then all the way down to his hands, where, of course, in this hand, he has a thing where he can shoot the blast out of his hands, and on this side, we have just a fist for punching everything, and I like how you can see, they'll focus the circle in there where it would be shooting out of. And then down his body, we got the legs, again, kind of just match the arm and design, again, carries on with the blue into the gold there that I really like. And all the way down to the legs, where the legs are just all solid red. They don't have any gold or silver or anything going on to them, just down into the legs. And then just have the engraving designs of the armor. Then on the back, you can see some more design going into it. They're probably on this area here, which probably has thrusters or something to help him fly. Which, of course, all he has to do is like point at the ground and stuff will shoot out his feet or whatever, and he'll fly. But there may be some extra stuff going on there, because usually that's where stuff shoots out. To help someone fly, you know, just shoot them out of the back. But So into the body, so we'll start with articulation, which again, this most of these characters are going to be the same. If they switch, I'll show you. But of course, normal with the head, you have the side-to-side rotation, and it can move up and down as well. Then in the shoulders, it's kind of a real stiff. Again, it's an Iron Man armor, so it's stiff and has limited movement. But it can move a little bit, and maybe if you loosen up more, it could move more. Then we have the like bicep spin there, and then of course, double elbow joints, so you can bend the elbow twice, and then the wrist joint, which again has a back and forth movement and then can twist around as well. So that's going to be the same on both arms. We do have some ab crunch there, but it's more like the upper abdomen right under the chest instead of a little bit lower down, it seems like. But it's got the upper part, so it can twist and crunch there. Then we have, of course, the hip joints, which have just normal articulation and movement. Then we have the upper thigh, which can twist around. So if you need to reposition the legs, you can. Double knee joint, which is kind of weird because it does have this big giant plate of armor in between the joint instead of just normal like kneecap covering. But it still works fine. And then, of course, with the foot, we have back and forth. And then it can twist side to side to help you get it to stand and move and articulate and all that. And then he doesn't come with any weapons or anything, but he does have different hands you can switch out. So it does come with a right hand that you can also use. So if you want to do the blast out of hand, so you can do both blasters, or if you want both fists, it does have a left hand fist as well, so you can switch them out that both fists or both things or just reverse hands. And then of course he does come with I don't know what you'd call this, but I'd say like the blast or something, so you can take them and stick them into his hand like that, and so he's like pew, shooting him at the bad guys and all that. And so he comes with both hands, so if you want to switch out the hands and put them in there as well, you can do that. So you can have like that on both hands. But just from his box, it says a sleek suit design and technological upgrades let Tony Stark gear up as the armored Avenger Iron Man. So he does not come with any parts for Thanos, which he's the only character that doesn't, which I think is kind of weird that he doesn't come with anything. But I guess they just, you know, there's 7 characters but only have 6 different parts for Thanos. But so I think that's fine. But that's going to be it for Iron Man. And next up here, we have Captain America. And so again, this is a version that we see revealed in the trailer. He's in this new, it's like his old outfit, but something's happened to it or changed on it. And it's more as if Captain America has kind of went into hiding after Civil War. Because we see him, you know, at the end of Civil War. And then he turns up like this in the new movie. And so in this, he's, like I said, he's got his like normal outfit, but it's all darker. So you can see it still has the red, white, red and white stripes going along on his stomach here, but now they're like a darker, so the white's almost gray, and then black's like a maroonish color, which you'll see up closer in a second. The star is off of his chest, so it's like the star has been ripped off, so it still has like the star, you know, indention there, but it's gone now and missing. And then now he's got the beard and everything as well, instead of just the normal baby-faced Captain America. So up close here, we have his face. So again, it's supposed to be the Chris Evans character. The face doesn't really look like him, but it, you know, gets the point across. But he's got the new hairstyle with the hair all slicked up in the front there. And then again, he's got the beard, as I mentioned before. The new look for Captain America there. Then going into a suit, so again, we have the missing star. And going into the white and blue, or yeah, white and red stripes. And again, the red looks kind of like a maroonish color, and the white looks grayish now because it's like all dark and dirty. Then on the sides, we have some armor, you know, on the arm, like the arm, shoulder plates. And then we've got a glove on one hand with the missing holes, which is very similar to what he had, again, in Civil War. And then on this side, he doesn't have any gloves at all, so he just got a normal hand there. Then going down, we got a belt. Oh, he does have the strap on his back, like on the sides here, going to his back where that holds on the shield. Then going down, we have a belt. So again, it's just a belt. It's got pockets and or some like pocket things. Of course, none of them open or anything, but they're just there for decoration. Then going to the pants, we do have the blue pants, continuing on with the blue suit with some of the more of the red, but looks more maroonish color stripes going down into it there. And then going into just some blackish brown. I can't tell what color they are. They look black, but almost brown at the same time. Boots there, of course, that are high up with the straps and everything. So that's really all there is to him. He doesn't have anything else going on with him. There's a look at the back. He's just like Iron Man, so has all the same articulation points and everything. Nothing has changed with him. But some stuff you can do different is he does come with some extra hands. So if you just want some fist hands instead of grip hands to hold stuff. You can switch them out. And then, of course, it doesn't have the glove on one of the hands. So just two bare hands that you can use. And then, of course, he does come with this new shield that we get that shows him using in Wakanda, because, of course, that's where we see him. And so he's got this Wakanda glove, where in the movie, I assume this is the second part where it kind of, like, fans out, because I know it's, like, closed off, and then, like, it fans open to reveal kind of claws like this. And so I assume that's already happened, and it's not the first part. And then, of course, I can't really get it into his hand, but you just stick it in his hand, and he just holds on to the handle here, and so he just holds it and uses it as a protection and shield. I assume these are made of vibranium as well, since they are in Wakanda, so it's going to be very similar to his shield, just a different sort of design. And in the movie, he does have one on each hand. And then for Thanos, we get his head. So this is our first part of Thanos here, and so we've got the head there, which I think looks very similar to the Thanos character, but he looks kind of weird. Like, his face looks a little bit weird. It looks like he has lipstick on almost. But we've got the head there for Thanos. And from his box, it says, "From the streets of Brooklyn to the intergalactic stage, Steve Rogers defends justice as Captain America." And so that's going to be it for this figure for Captain America. And next up here, we have Iron Spider. So, of course, this is Spider-Man in his new suit that Tony Stark has provided for him. And they're calling it the Iron Spider, because the figure doesn't really show up, but, like, it, in the movie or other toy stuff. And what the Iron Spider is he has, like, legs that, metal legs or iron legs, if you want to call them, that come out of the back. And then his suit's just kind of more technology. So it's like Iron Man, but with a Spider-Man suit. And so, of course, this has a really cool design with the red and blue and then all the gold and stuff that goes through it for the technology. And then I think it's kind of cool. So size-wise, his character is smaller, which I really like that they did that. So here's Captain America next to it. So you can get kind of like a scale difference. They're not that much, but you can tell, you know, that the Spider-Man figure is shorter. Of course, since it is played by Tom Holland, you know, a shorter kid, and, you know, as Spider-Man usually is a younger kid, should be smaller. So I really like that they did that. So up close here, we have the Spider-Man face, which doesn't really look any different. Of course, all his paint is, I was going to say kind of metallic, but I guess it's not really. It's just kind of like a darker red. But on the face, though, it doesn't look any different. It's just got normal-looking eyes. We don't know yet if, you know, it's the eyes that, like, can change, you know, and react to his facials and everything. It just looks like normal there. Then going down to his suit. So, again, we've got the gold plating around the spider that I really like, and it just spreads throughout his outfit. Like, the normal Spider-Man outfit just redesigned with this gold armor added into it. Then we go to his hands. Of course, he's got the gotta do the Spider-Man hands, you know, shooting the web out of his wrist. So we've got the double hands there. And then, so that's it. So again, you know, looks just like the normal Spider-Man outfit. Going down, you've got like the belt area there. And then going into pants now, the blue here is definitely a metallic color. I could definitely tell that that's metallic. Going into his shoes there, back to the red. So for articulation, since this is a Spider-Man, it is different. So he has the normal head, so side to side on up and down movement there. But then on the shoulders here, he does have, you know, the normal up and down movements of the shoulder, you know, can twist and all that, and forearm or bicep there, double elbow joint, and then the wrist can spin as well. But then he does also have like a butterfly joint here on the arm, so it can like twist back, not twist, but like go back, so it looks like he's broke his arm almost. And then you can do it forward a little bit more than just the normal stationary to the side in the movement. So that's kind of cool that it does have like that butterfly joint there on the back. Then it's got, of course, the ab crunchers as usual, and then all the other normal body parts. So this one actually does spin. I may have missed that on Iron Man. I may have missed it on Captain America, but of course the waist spin there, then hip, upper thigh, double knee, and then the ankle joint there as well. So all of that, the Spider-Man is the same, just the shoulder is pretty much all that's different. And then they, of course, made him different height. He doesn't come with any hands or anything, I'm surprised, because usually when they come with Spider-Man, they come with either some webbing or some, like, different hands, like fists or something that you can switch out, or, you know, maybe a head or something. But he doesn't come with anything. All he comes with is one, the left leg for Thanos. So there's, of course, Thanos' leg. So he's going to be a pretty big guy, like, you know, his one leg is like over half the size of Spider-Man. So he's going to be a big build-a-figure. But from the box, it says, "Advanced technology and high-tech gear are signature marks of the web-slinging hero Iron Spider." So right there, we got some info on Spider-Man and his advanced suit. So that's going to be it for Iron Spider. And so this is our last character from the actual movie characters, and this is Proxima Midnight. And again, as I mentioned before, she's a member of the Black Order and like a right-hand person to Thanos, one of his four guys that you'll see in the movie. Or at least I believe it's four people. But this character, I like the way she's designed, but she is tall. So just again, so it's opposite of Spider-Man. We'll bring Captain America in here to show the size difference between the two now. So now Captain America looks like Spider-Man was. And then just for even more scale, we will bring Spider-Man back here too. So you can see the height difference between all the different characters. So I like that she is a lot taller compared to the normal characters. I like that addition of detail into her. So this character, I don't know who she is. Like, I've heard her name before and I've seen, you know that she's a member of the Black Order. But other than that, I don't know what she's supposed to look like. But this looks very alien-ish and very much in, like, a video game. I can't remember what game I want to say. I want to say, like, Mass Effect or something. But I don't know if that's what it would be, but it reminds me something from there. So here's an up close look at her. So there's her face. So she has these horns coming off of her head, and then she has all these red dots all over her head that I think is weird. But then we got her face. So it's got like a lighter blue, or it's like a lightish gray with a blue mixture, and then gray definitely like at the head and horns. Then she's got long blue hair, as you can see going down there. And then into her body here, we do have some pieces of armor on her left hand. So got this gold armor going down her left hand, and not so much on her right, just a part on her like gauntlets or forearms there. And then she's got this swirly or wavy detail design, as you can kind of see there on her chest, and it just goes all throughout her body between the black and the white parts, or dark gray and black and white parts there. And it's just swirled or like waved in and out all the way through. Again, it's even on her hands all the way down her legs, and then now on her legs she kind of switches out, so she's got the armor parts on her right leg and not her left. So it's, you know, right arm or left arm, right leg, and then it's mixture without any pieces. But there's a look at her again with more of the gold going down, and then nothing on the left leg. And then there's a look at the back. Nothing really special. Looks exactly the same there on the back. But this is a female, so there may be a little bit different articulation. So on the head, so of course we have normal head movements, up and down, turn, elbow or shoulder joints, which this one can't move very much because of this plating. But this one should, yeah, be able to have more movement. It's got the same bicep, you know, double elbow and wrist. Then we have right under her chest, we have the like movement. She doesn't move a whole lot, but she does have some movement. No twisting of the waist or anything. But then we have the thigh or the hip, upper thigh, double knee, and then a little bit of movement going on in the foot, especially on this leg. There's probably more on this leg, which it's stuck right now. And then, but then you can't twist sides. Like, look, she can completely break her leg. It looks crazy. But you have that twisting movement there to help her stand. So she does come with a weapon, which I think is cool. And so she has this staff that looks, you know, kind of like a trident. I don't know if those are supposed to be three, like, knives or, you know, points or something that can, like, stab into somebody. I don't know. We'll have to see once the movie comes out exactly what she does with this, or if maybe it shoots energy. I don't know. But it's just a weird sort of staff. It looks very much like alien technology. It looks like, you know, this side could almost be a gun or something. Or it's just some weird design staff, you know, that has all this extra stuff on it for no reason. But you can obviously put that in her hand to hold that. And she doesn't come with anything else besides that, but she does have the body for Thanos. So there's, you know, Thanos' giant body of his chest and waist area there. So we have got that part for Thanos. But from her box, it says, "A lieutenant of the Black Order, Proxima Midnight serves Thanos in his quest for the ultimate power." And so there we go for Proxima Midnight. And next up here, we have Taskmaster. So this is the first of the comic characters. So these are not seen in the movie, at least not that we know of yet. But these versions are definitely the comic versions and not ones that would be in the movie. So this is the original Taskmaster. As I mentioned to a couple sets ago, maybe a year or so ago, we did get another Taskmaster that's more of like a modern version. And it was more like armored and metallic. But this is more of his original outfit of the blue and the orange and white mixture that I really like, and I think he looks like such a cool character. So up close here, you can see he does have a skull face, which I was gonna see, you know, compared to the Ghost Rider we did not too long ago. His mouth does not move, so it's just a normal skull face. But again, I really like the detail in that. He does have a hood that looks like you could probably maybe take it off. I don't know for sure. It's kind of stuck on there, so maybe not. It may be permanently attached to his head. Then he's got a cape here. Again, it's this plastic cape that I do not like, and because it doesn't really stick. It's got, you know, a peg that goes into the back but doesn't hold into it. But I do like, though, that it does have the piece that comes around here and attaches with the chain. Tell pulled it on, so even if it falls out of the hole, it doesn't completely fall off of him. It still stays on. Then we have the orange part up here. It's just some detail or something. Not really supposed to be any logos or anything. And then going into his arm, so we got the blue collar going into the orange, like a burnt orange collar. And then the white gloves. That, again, I like these kind of gloves on characters. I think they look cool. And then, so of course, then on the, I forgot to say, on the cape, we've got the orange on the inside here that, to match his outfit. Then going down, we've got a belt on him, and it's, so we have the Taskmaster logo, which is like a T inside of a circle. We've got some pockets along his belt, but nothing much more detailed than that. He's got white underwear on, going more into blue legs, and he's got some straps over here. He has a holster for a pistol that's, you know, strapped on, then just side, it's just like a piece of strapping or a bell or something on his leg. Doesn't look like it'll do much of anything. Going down into his legs where he has the shoes, very similar, the gloves and shoes are very similar to the original Captain America. They're just white instead of the red. But I really like all of that detail and design into Taskmaster. Now, of course, since this is Taskmaster, he does come with a shield. So again, there's the thing. It's supposed to be, I don't know if it's supposed to be his logo. To me, like, special in here, it looks like a T, you know, for Taskmaster, and it'd be that way. But, you know, like there, it's like a Y or something. I don't know. But it's funny. So this is just like a Captain America shield that's been, like, repainted. I'm saying toy-wise. I don't know if it is in the, you know, comics or anything, if that's what this is. But so it's got the yellow T or orange T and then the blue on the outside, and it's got that white circle in the middle as well. And so you do have the part here, the peg that you can, you know, stick into the hand so we can hold it, or you have can flip it over, which is kind of stuck, it feels like, to that, and then you can grip it onto their hands like that, so it's stuck on the side of his hands. And then I'm sure if we want to take the cape off or something, you could flip this back and then stick this into the back of his cape to help it hold on to the back. Then he does come with a gun, so you can use a gun with him, and then of course you can stick it into the holster down here into the side. But Taskmaster is like an ultimate, like, weapons specialist person, so he uses all sorts of weapons like the gun and a sword. So we have the sword here as well that has the gold color in it that you can use or place it with him. And this is very similar to Zemo, or what's his name? I think it's Zemo. Was a character I had bought a few years ago, like a couple years ago now, in a Marvel Legends, and he came with a sword just like this and a gun, just different colors than the metallic. I think it was just more of a yellow or something, but it looked very much similar to this. But there's all the stuff we get for Taskmaster. And then he does come with the right leg of Thanos, so again, we got another leg there, building up Thanos. And from his box, an expert of mimicry, Taskmaster copies the stunts and skills of his opponents to beat them at their own game. So again, he can, like anybody he goes against and fights, he can see how they're fighting, mimic it, and be able to fight them back with it. And I think that's cool. So that's going to be it for Taskmaster. And next up here, we have Songbird. So this is a character I don't know much about at all, but I know she has been a member of the Avengers in the past. And so that's probably why she's included into this, and they've, you know, not made a character of her before. But I really like this look and color of her, like with the pinkish and white and then the blue color as well. I really like the way it looks all put together. So we'll move up close here. So of course, here's her head. And so she's got the white hair with the like pinkish red color in the front. It's like a dark pink almost, going into the front designs, you know, and goes down through her hair. Then we got her face there, and she's got some bright pink lipstick going on. And then we go into her armor, and so she's got some gold plating up top here with one of the pink, it's like almost like a V shape or something there on her, whatever you call this, like chest plate. And I like that pink color they chose. Then going into white, that kind of has like a birdish design. It's hard to tell, but you'll see some closer to it later, but it's got that design. Then on her arm, she's just got some gold gauntlets going on, and then both of her hands are in flat form. It's almost like the Flash running hands, but I guess that's just what she does. Then going down into her belt, so she has a gold belt, and I wish they would just, like, attach these belts. I hate, you know, how it can move around like this. I wish they would just attach it on, but it's got the pink circle there in the middle. Again, I like that pink color they chose. And then going down into legs, we've got from transforming from blue into the white, and then we've got some of the blue stripes going into the legs there, and then they're just plain and basic legs. And so this is like the classic female form, so she does have, you know, the real skinny arms, and then has like the weird movement of her elbows and everything that you can do. It's not the double jointed ones, it's just a single joint that can move around, and then because of her armor and stuff, she can move in all weird ways. And then so she's just got real skinny joints, so if you like move these a lot and stuff, you'll have to be really careful not to break any part of her legs or anything. The only part she comes with is this giant peak thing. I don't know what it's supposed to be, but it sticks into her back, so she has a hole in the back that you can place this into and stick her on it like that. So there's where you get like the bird, and that's kind of what the design down here is, what's on her chest almost. But I really like this like neon or hot pink color they chose. I don't know if it comes across the same color as it does on the camera, but in real life it looks really cool. But it looks like it's supposed to be some sort of like an elemental or but like an energy thing forming around her to give her wings. And then of course it shows her with her hands down to her side and stuff, like, so she probably just flies like this, like like that or something. But that's what she comes with. And then she does come with the right arm of Thanos, so there we've got one of the arms of Thanos there. And from her box it says, a cacophony of skill and supersonic powers make Melissa Gold the high-pitched hero songbird. So she must do some sort of like screaming or yelling, probably like a black canary type figure. But that's going to be it for Songbird. And our last character here is the leader of the Serpent Society. I don't know if he has another name. The box just labels him as Serpent Society, but he's obviously the leader of the group. But we do get his real name that I'll read off here in a little bit. But I like the way this guy looks. So he's all purple and green. So again, he kind of goes along, you know, with the Hulk and whichever goblin is the purple and green one. And it's a lot of characters just are purple and green. He's very similar to the Prowler we did in the last set, or one of the last sets, in color was in everything, but I think it's still kind of cool. So up top here, we'll move up and we've got his head. So again, he's got this green hood on it, and it's all he's a lot of metallic colors, pretty much all of it's metallic except for the black on him. But we've got his head up here, it's a metallic green, and so up top we have a cobra head, which is going to be kind of hard to see. You can see it from the side there, but it's got a cobra head, and then I assume that's what's supposed to be around his face, you know, with the cobra's head fanned out around here like this. But it's a hood on him, which I think you could maybe take off. Oh, maybe not. Maybe it's stuck to his head. I thought you'd take it off. But then we've got he's got a green face on, of course, that looks like little fangs hanging down. So it's supposed to be, like, you know, like a snake's mouth, or with the fangs and everything coming down on his face. But there is a guy under there, as you can see. Then we go into a cape, which I think is really cool, and looks like you can probably just take off. It just barely grips on there with these circle parts. But I really like the inside, the detail of it. It looks like, you know, the neck of a king cobra, with the, like, segmented parts on it that I really like. And then on the back, it's just kind of flat with these two lines going down. You can still kind of see some of the marks from the inside part going there. So I really like his cape design on that. Then going into his body, we've got the purple chest with a black snake head, as you can see there. It's kind of hard to see in the light. But again, all the purple's metallic. Then he's got green arms, and it's a scaly green, and it's all metallic as well, going into his hands as well. Then we've got his gauntlets on, which are just a metallic, like silver or gray color. And it's got some designs in there with the two lines of design, probably like holding it together. Then we've got just a normal belt, and again it's the metallic like gray color of a belt. It's just a belt with a circle in the center. And then we go into his legs with more of the green scales down into his shoes, which is, I don't know if you can see in the camera, but in the front, so it's black on the front here, but on the sides, like back here, it's like a really dark metallic green. You may not be able to see it that well, but I like the way they detail. This is, like, look-wise and stuff, probably my favorite character out of the set, just because of the colors and his whole look that they put into this. I really like that. He doesn't come with any weapons, but we do get Thanos' left hand, of course, with the Infinity Gauntlet. And as you can see, he does have all the Infinity Stones on there, so we've got the green, purple, blue, red, orange, and yellow. So we do have all the stones there. Maybe a spoiler for the movie. I hope not. But I mean, you'd think he would get all the stones anyways. But you never know. He may not get them all in this first movie or anything. But we do have his hand for that. So from the box, it says, the leader of the Serpent Society, Klaus Voorhees, uses powerful venom to strike down his enemies. And so that sounds pretty cool. And so that's going to be it for the leader of the Serpent Society. So we now have all of Thanos' parts, so we can begin to start to put him together now, which of course I will do off camera because I always have some issues with it. But I'll go ahead and put Thanos all together, and then we'll take a look at him at the very end. So we've got Thanos all put together here. So as you can see, I'm kind of very disappointed with this Thanos, like the look and color of him. Building-wise, he was probably one of the easiest characters I've ever built. He went together super easily and had no issues at all. But just for some size scale, I'll bring Captain America back in here. So there's a look at the size. You can see how big Thanos is. And then just for some more detail, we'll put in Proxima Midnight next to him so you can see. So she's about the same height as him, just a little bit shorter than that. So you can get a kind of like a scale size of how he fits compared to the figures. But I don't like that they did this in the movie. Of course, they changed it. When we first saw Thanos from like the first Avengers movie and stuff, when it showed him, you know, like sitting in his chair out in the galaxy, wherever that is. We saw him in more of like a classic detail, classic looking outfit. But this time they've made it more like a more modern, you know, to make it more fit in with the Marvel movie. So they got rid of his helmet, which I know it does show him wear a helmet at some point in the movie. But this, when we see him mostly, he doesn't have the helmet. So I don't like, again, the way they made his face look. Oops, sorry about that. So again, there's a look at his face. And I just don't like that very much. Then going into his armor, I like this piece. I wish this part would just carry over. So like the chest part going into like this detailed design would carry out through. But it just kind of ends, you know, it goes down to his belt and stops. And then, so he's got bare arms, so he's, you know, wearing like a tank top, you know, sun's out, guns out type thing. Then we've got the Infinity Gauntlet on his hand, which is perfectly fine. I like the gauntlet and everything. I like they put all the gems in him. Then on his belt, he does has like this like cloth hanging down off the back, which I think is a nice design. I don't have any issues with that. Like I said, I wish they just added more. Then he's just got like normal black leather pants, it looks like. Then he's got some on his boots down here, some parts protecting his knees that are like this gold armor there. And so he does have movement still. So he does have the double jointed knees. So nothing changes there. He's got all the same movements as all the other characters. Nothing's different about him. And then, of course, just his black shoes there as well. So it's just not that standout of a character. I like the detail, the pop. Like I said, that's why I like the Serpent Society guy. Because his detail, or his colors and everything, just pop and all the detail put into him. And Thanos, they've just made him so plain and basic and boring. And so that's why it's kind of part that's, if anything, has helped me lose interest in the movie is the Thanos. I wish they just changed him up and made him look different. But I think it's still going to be really cool, and I can't wait to see the movie. Again, we will have the review out by the Friday of the day the movie comes out, sometime that night. So you can come back to our channel and watch that if you haven't done so already, and if you want to know our opinions on the movie, that will be there as well. So I hope you check that out. But that's it for this video, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, let me know in the comments down below. Let me know which character out of the set is your favorite. Who do you like the best? Mine's obviously Captain America. He's my favorite hero out of all, so he's definitely my favorite. But let me know what yours is down below, and don't forget to subscribe to see more Marvel Legend videos, and we'll see you next time.